Young California DJ Philly Bell. Young California, we here with the man, DJ Felly Fell, the heavy hitter, the beat maker, producer, DJ extraordinaire. What's up, man?
Hello, bro. Thanks for having me, brother.
It's all good. You actually produce a lot of the records that you have heard on air throughout the past years.
Ironically enough, I've actually been producing at roughly the same amount of time as I've been DJing. Basically, I was DJing at a house party. This guy showed up, you know, with his turntables, and he had a beat machine, and it was a SP-1200, you know, old school analog beat machine. And I had always seen that beat machine in rap videos. I was like, oh man, that's that beat machine. You know, he taught me how to run it. I was real anxious and curious. That led into producing the beats, and eventually I evolved into a music producer.
Now go ahead and name some of the hits that you've had like on the radio.
The biggest record that I had on the radio was Get Buck in Here.
Telly on the telly with a couple of twins, cause tonight damn right we gonna do it again.
Which was a record that I was really proud of because it landed me a record deal with Def Jam. It was featuring Diddy, Akon, Ludacris, and Lil Jon. Another record that I'm real proud of is my current song, Reason to Hate, which is featuring Neo on the hook, Tyga, and Wiz Khalifa. Another one of my favorites, which might be my actual favorite record that I produced, is a record I did with Baby Bash featuring Keith Sweat.
I really like that one.
The Don't Stop.
That one was actually really big in the Bay Area.
Oh, word.
It was huge. Also, Finer Things, I really
like
that one.
Finer Things is another one that I really like. That one was with Kanye and Neo and Fabulous and Jermaine Dupri. Slightly different direction with the Boomerang record, you know,
right,
which was more of a fist pump party record with Pitbull and Akon and Jermaine.
Take me through like the process of when you sit down and start to make a beat. Do you usually start with a melody first, or do you kind of hop into the drums first?
I start with the melody first. You know, I like to do the pretty stuff first, and then bring that beat in.
I was like, who do I hear on this record? The first thing I do is I get a hook, and I hadn't done a record with Neo since my Finer Things record, and I knew he would sound good on this record. Tyga came to mind. And then this guy came to mind.
What digital audio workstation do you use? Logic, Reason?
I use Logic. I do a lot. I still use, it's funny, I was talking about the SP-1200. I still use that SP, you know, to give it that fat, you know, analog, you know, sound.
So do you usually mix your own records, like when you dump them into Pro Tools? Or do you kind of do you have a go-to engineer, a go-to mastering person?
Once I've produced a record, you know, I've heard it from the first snare, the keyboard to the last vocal. You can get caught up and lost in a record. I work better having somebody else mix my records and I make notes.
Do you ever I call it demo-itis, where you make a beat, you get a rough mix on there, sounds cool, sounds good, then you get it back from the engineer, you're like, man.
Oh yeah. They're gonna take your record that sounds like this, and when it comes back, it's gonna sound like this. And it's your job to get in there and say, I still want it to be big, but I need it to look more like my picture, but just bigger.
As a DJ, does it help you keep your ear to the streets as far as like what your next record is gonna sound like?
Being on the radio, you know, my job is to take in all these records and determine which ones are hits, and then seeing certain records evolve, you know, just over the years, I think it's just, now it's subconscious. When I get in the studio, you know, I know exactly what sound I'm looking for, and for the most part, how to achieve it. And if I don't know how to achieve it, then I've grown now into the type of producer, I know how I'm gonna get that sound. I know who I can go to. There was a time where I was like, I don't want anybody's help. You know, I wanna produce it all. I don't want anybody saying that, you know, I didn't produce that record. A true producer is doing that. They're conducting. It's your birthday, bitch.
Thank you for interviewing with us, man.
Anytime, bro. I appreciate you. Young California.